candidates. Before you is Mr. Logie Joshua, and I'm going to take you through the second method of measuring or approximating the area under a curve or the area of an irregular figure. This is my second method. I call it the trapezium rule. Now this method, trapezium rule, is just but derived from the word trapezium. For instance, I have a graph here showing a curve of the function y is equal to x raised to power n. You sketch that curve, you will get a curve of this kind. Now in this my curve, I can end up obtaining certain number of trapezia from this my curve. Now from this my curve, I'll have the following trapezia. I'll have the first trapezium here, I'll have the second trapezium, I'll have the third trapezium, and then this number of trapezia will continue up to the end trapezium. Now this my sketch here is only giving me the number of trapezia that I'm now going to use to derive the trapezoidal rule, or what I simply call the trapezium rule. Now from the concept of trapezium, which is a regular figure, trapezium being a regular figure, we know that if this is my trapezium, then I'll have three measurements. I'll have the base or the edge length, then I'll have the two parallel sides. I'll have side A being parallel to side B. In this my figure here, being regular, we all know that the area of a trapezium is simply a half h into A plus B. That is the formula for getting the area of a trapezium. I'll want us to use this concept to derive the formula which I call the trapezium rule formula. In this case, I want us to refer to this figure. The distance of these lines above the x-axis, I want us to call them y0, y1, y2, up to where I'll have the last y, that is yn. And then if you want to get the area of this figure bound by this curve, the line x is 0 and the line x is n, then I want to get my h, and the h here is simply the distance from the first x value to the second, or the second x value to the third, or the third to the fourth, up to the last x. And this h here must be constant. So I have a constant h. So that is what I'm going to use here as my a half into h. But now come to the first trapezium. The area is going to be a half h into y naught plus y1. And this half h remains constant. So I'll continue. I'll now have y1 plus y2. I'll go to y2 plus y3. I'll continue in that order till I'll have the second last y, which is yn minus 1 plus yn, the all of this. Then I want us to consider this thing that I'm writing down. What is half h into y0 plus y1 all the way up to yn? You realize that in this formula I'm trying to derive that y0 and yn appears once, but the rest of the y's appear twice each. Therefore, I'll have my a half h still maintained
Then I'll have the bigger bracket. Then the ones that appear once, the y naught and yn, I'll have it as y naught plus yn. But there's no need of multiplying that by 1 here. I'll just have y naught plus yn because they appear once each. But now the rest will appear twice. So I'll have 2 into y1, y2, y3, y4 plus y minus 1 in bracket, then the bigger bracket occurring between half h and the last yn minus 1, and this is what I call my trapezoidal rule, or what I simply call the trapezium rule. Now for us to understand this rule better and simplify it further, I want us to consider an example. My example, I want us to sketch the graph of y is equal to x squared minus 5. And sketching this graph, I'll obtain this. This is the graph I'll obtain. But this graph, I want us to sketch it between the range of 0 to 3. That is my first value of x is 0, and the last value of x is 3. Then if my first value of x is 0 and my last value of x is a 3, then I need to get my h, the h that I'm going to use. It is my trapezoidal formula, the h that I have here. This my h, as we can remember, we are going to have the last value of x, which is 3, or simply the last value of x, which is xn minus x naught, all over the number of trapezium. The number of trapezium. In this case, my h that I'm going to use, this is the formula we'll be using to get the h that will use in calculating the area using the trapezoidal rule. Where I'll have my h is the last value of x minus the first value of x, then I divide by the number of trapezium. Now in this case, my h is going to be the last x, which was 3. And my first x is 0. So when I take 3, I subtract 0, I divide by the number of trapezium, which I'm told to be 6, then I'm getting my h to be 0.5. Now this 0.5 is what I'm going to use to draw this my grid. This my grid. Now the grid is simply from 0 to 3, the domain given in the example. So I'll have my first value as 0, but from one boundary of the first trapezium to the next, there's a range of 0.5, which is the h. So I'll add 0.5 to 0. I'll get 0.5, then I'll have 1, 1.5, 2, 2.5, and 3. When you substitute these values in the function y is equal to x squared minus 5, you will obtain these values of y. These values of y's are obtainable. They are obtained in the graph that I've drawn. So the first value of y is from here to here. The second value from here to here. The third value from here to here. From here to here, and I've called them y naught, y1, y3, y2, y3, y4, y5, y6. And I've simply summarized those values of y as shown as 5, 4.75, 4, 2.75, 1, 1.25, and 4. Now in the grid, you'll see that the values are negative, which is okay. But getting the area, we will use the absolute values of y's. which I now have all the values to be positive. These are what I substitute here. So I'll have a half by 0.5, which was my h, then 5 plus 4, because they appear once, this and this, even in the graph, but the rest will appear twice. So I'll have a half by 0.5 into 9, then plus 2 into 13.75, which gives me 0.25 into 9 plus 27.5. Going further, I'll have 9 plus 27.5 as 36.5, multiplied by 0.25 gives me the area as 9.125 square units. This is the area bound by the curve x is 0 and x is 3 using the trapezoidal rule. That is 9.125. Thank you very much.